Hi, everybody. Father Frisoni with you. Greetings and thanks for joining us. Well, we have a little reprieve this week, weather-wise. Now, don't tell my mother. Shh. No earmuffs. 46 degrees and sun trying to pierce the clouds, so not too bad this week. We've been pummeled so far in 2021, so we need a little reprieve. I hope you're doing great, and I wanted to share with you a few reflections that I've had to encounter in the past few weeks involving stays at various hospitals. A number of people have lost their mothers, their fathers, their relatives who have had to go to hospital to get better, but it did not happen that way, and may they rest in peace. And so many persons found themselves in the regular rooms or in the intensive care units. And as you know, we are certainly battling the insidious virus, the epidemic that we find ourselves engaged in this battle. And because we are with this illness, there are certain regulations that do not permit families to be with loved ones as before the epidemic, such as in the waiting rooms or even in their patient rooms. And so this is very difficult for family members. And so the person who is sick goes from here to here. The person that died, may they rest in peace, went from the hospital eventually to the cemetery without their relatives or friends being able to visit them in the hospital room before they died. And a number of people have told me about an anguish, a hole in the heart, to lose someone so close without any notice that there begins some kind of malady that may or may not be related to the current virus, but some problem on an acute basis begins and they deteriorate rapidly in the hospital and there is no ability to visit to say goodbye to their loved one. And so we must reflect this week about the judgment process in light of the virus, but also in light of the need for emotional support and comfort. And so it's worth a reflection on what is the judgment process. What are the goods that we have to judge as people of God? Obviously, it is important to stay as healthy and as safe as possible. We don't want to get sick, and we don't want anybody else to get sick. And so, we have to be most careful how we keep our distance from people so that we are not spreading something that we really don't know too much about right now, except that for some people it's a very deadly bug. And so the first good that we try to uphold is to keep everybody safe and healthy. That's one side of the coin, one good. But there's also another good that we have to consider. Comfort and love for one's mother, one's father, one's husband, or one's wife. Are you aware of the difficulty of losing a loved one when being unable to say goodbye before they fell asleep in the Lord? That could lead to a variety of challenges later on in life, but especially having to live with the fact that I could never say goodbye to my loved one in the hospital. Now, of course, if there was a sudden accident, may God forbid, then there would not be any ability whatsoever to say a goodbye in a hospital. But when there is a lag time of a few days, maybe a week or two, or a month when someone is in intensive care, yet the new rules may be that one cannot enter the hospital to say goodbye. That is a very, very difficult response. And so that's the second good to weigh, that There needs to be a bond and a connection with someone, even if we haven't been able to say that during the living years, that we are able to say that right at the very end. And I know that's not possible in every situation. Two goods to balance then. Good number one, the good of staying safe and healthy, but the second good of being close to one's loved one and being able to say goodbye, that they are close and that the only experience for that person and for you is not going to be at just the cemetery, being able to pray, because it's so hard to lose one's mother and one's father or any loved one. And so in the judgment process, I hope you realize by now there are two goods that have to be weighed, and that the selection is not 100% zero. That a selection of option one or option two will involve costs and benefits, and that there's not some precise answer that is 100% perfect. And we do that all of the time, but we don't realize that. The purpose of this week's promotion to the vision of our Lord with Peter and James and John on the mountain, along with the ancestors in faith, is to promote the view for us that we must include the Lord in our vision and in our judgment-making process. I am not a politician, and I am not a scientist. I'm just someone trying to shed the light of faith on a common problem that we have right now. Maybe there's some kind of concession or some kind of way to balance both of these goods so that we keep everybody safe and healthy, but that we allow somebody's son or daughter or husband or wife or sister or brother to have one last goodbye, especially if it is in intensive care and a person is close to falling asleep in the good Lord. There has to be these ways to weigh the options, but we do that with the eye toward the Lord who said, I have come that they may have life and life to the fullest. Do not be afraid of any kind of external force or fear or situation or even virus. Yes, we must be vigilant. Don't misunderstand. We must be precautious, but we must also put our cares on the good Lord, and that should something happen, the Lord will help us through the pain and the cross and the trial of that moment. And so in this weighing, we have to have a vision of Jesus near us, in front of us, and behind us while we weigh these various options. When we gaze on the mountain, we may see just trees or snow with the trees in this season. But I hope for a person of faith, you realize that the Lord is walking with us. And so that means that God must be part of the judgment-making process, and that the gospel of life that He has come to lift us up must be part of our decision-making and how we weigh life's challenges. And so none of us may be hospital executives, or maybe there might be someone tuning in, but we are all people of faith along the way, and we must pray for those who have to weigh these big decisions, but also with the possibility of knowing the pain and the hurt, the loss and the anger that someone experiences when a loved one leaves this earth and dies and is in the hands of God, but that relative must live on for years, maybe decades, nobody knows, only the good Lord, and that we must take into account that person as well, not just the virus. That we are all on this earth and journey together, and as people of God, we can come to a common solution, but based in love and based in care. And so I hope in your vision this week, if you have big decisions to weigh in your life, that you may incorporate the good Lord in those decisions. And don't be afraid to enter into the experience of God by direct prayer to God, not just something we do on a Sunday or as you're watching this broadcast here, for which we thank you, but that God is alive and all around you, Monday through Saturday and all the days of the week too. That the Lord guide your decisions and that you enter the heart and open the door of the heart to the good Lord. Peace be with you, everyone. Take good care.
Still alive.